That's supposed to be the best water for making beer from.
Right, where are we going then?
We're driving to Nottingham.
Why are we doing that?
To see some Tesla coils. So it's what's known as a Gaussfest.
It's a works outing.
Well, it's a fact-finding mission for Project Awesome. Seems like we've been on motorways for hours.
And then right on this one.
This one?
Yeah.
So right here.
Yeah.
Roger that. It's all gone a bit oldie-worldy, hasn't it?
Mm. This is the postcode.
There's the
pumping station.
So let's have a look. There's a Jacob's ladder done properly.
Making quite difficult to tell.
So in here, that's forms a spark gap, and what's happening is you're giving it a really high voltage power supply, charging up the capacitor bank, which is all resonant through the spark gap. Ours doesn't have a spark gap, it does it with transistors instead.
What we're measuring there, Mark?
Well, this is accelerometer data, so it's meaningless. It's this that I'm interested in, which is the magnetic flux.
Fancy electrocuting yourself?
Yeah, I'll have a go. Yeah, like a very mellow electric friend.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah, very good stuff.
Yeah. My great grandfather, in about the early 1900s, before 1910 anyway, had a patent on an electric alarm clock. I would energise two induction coils on either side of the clock. The idea was you woke up, you grabbed hold of them, and gave yourself a shock in the morning.
Well, the amount is a duo, I think it's a duo, and that's what I'm great. 1930s, I've got a photo of it, and that one was one where the electrode would actually attach to things to wake them up. You know, that's a pretty horrifying one, you know, so.
Field strength. This has got much higher voltage, big capacitor bank. It's discharging through the spark gap, causing the electric field in the primary to collapse. That should technically all be worked out with the value of the capacitors, the length of the spark gap, to the actual resonance of the coils. It's all got to be in tune and in resonance. But they just work on one fixed frequency then.
That can just do that then.
That's all that does.
Yeah.
I think they just work at a fixed frequency. Whereas this thing is exactly the same as the one that I've made. It's got a resonant frequency of that one. It's probably like 300 kilohertz, something like that. But that's being switched on and off at audio frequency. Around the corner there, he's got a couple of slightly smaller ones there as well. But that's the only solid state ones that I've seen here so far. All the ones down that end are all traditional spark gap coils. There's not that many people building big solid-state coils.
Nobody said no, so...
No.
One CD formatted.
Churchiness of it. Yeah, they make a proper effort, didn't they, the Victorians?
So Mark, have you enjoyed your day out?
Yes, it's been awesome. Project awesome.
Like and subscribe.
Don't do it.